The U.S. condemns Iran after the rogue regime announced it's ramping up its enrichment of uranium. Iranians say they will break from the 2015 landmark nuclear deal and pass the limit of what they are allowed to stockpile within 10 days. Now the U.S. is weighing its next steps. Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby has been following this story. He reports from the State Department.
Good evening, Lauren. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo says the U.S. is considering a full range of options with Iran. He says taking military action is one of those possibilities, but President Trump has made it clear he does not want to go to war. State Department spokesperson Morgan Ortega says one thing's for certain: the administration will not allow Iran to acquire a nuclear weapon.
We, you know, would say to the international community that we should not yield to nuclear extortion by the Iranian regime.
Morgan Ortega blasted Iran today for violating its own commitment to the international community by ratcheting up its uranium enrichment levels. A spokesman for Iran's atomic agency explained how his country had increased its uranium production fourfold. The move is likely aimed at putting pressure on Europe. Iran's president, Hassan Rouhani, says the 2015 nuclear deal can be saved and a resolution can be reached if European countries circumvent U.S. sanctions. President Donald Trump first imposed the sanctions after he withdrew the U.S. from the deal in May of 2018. Since then, the White House has engaged in what it calls a maximum pressure campaign. Middle East analyst Jim Phillips says Iran is feeling the impact.
And the fact that the Trump administration didn't give waivers really ratcheted up pressure much higher than Iran expected. And so this year, it's ejected its patient policy and it's ratcheted up tension.
Phillips says that includes last week's attacks on two oil tankers traveling near the Strait of Hormuz in the Persian Gulf. The U.S. says video evidence shows Iranian groups are to blame. But European foreign ministers, who are meeting today, say they want more evidence before wading into a potential diplomatic conflict.
Secretary Pompeo and the acting defense secretary, Patrick Shanahan, have urged its European allies to join the U.S. in its maximum pressure campaign. But many European leaders are hoping to salvage the nuclear deal. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says the international community should reinstate sanctions if Iran follows through on its threats. Lauren?
Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby reporting from the State Department. Thank you, Wyatt.